Poly universities.
Cal Poly Florida. Cal Poly has always been innovative.
Cal Poly's far out frequencies.
Far out frequencies.
Thank God.
My goodness gracious. Those students, they're brilliant and they're so passionate. They created this themselves.
This is the only student built.
Designed and built by the students. Not professionals, by these students.
Thousands of hours go in by volunteers to decorate each of this, just like this Cal Poly float.
The St. Louis Obispo campus students drove 4 hours every weekend for most of the year to get this thing done.
All decorated, designed, and produced by students.
But I cannot speak enough about what these students have done together.
It's neat. I mean, it's only this much stuff. It's a small amount. But it was just kind of like my backpack or my cubby or my glove compartment of where I kept my stuff for life. And now I'm passing it on to the next person who just wants to keep their stuff here alive. It's nostalgic, for sure. It's not bad. It's weird transitioning.
How does it feel?
It's not bad, you know, on to newer and better things, and just progressing in my future, and at the same time, I know almost exactly as I close that locker, I'm kind of closing that page in my history, and it's weird. It's progressive, but, you know, it's like already feeling like, man, that's history, that's the past, that's something I'm remembering that I used to do, and since I just closed that locker, it's really fresh.
Gonna take a year.
So
as you see, we are almost done and got really close to a lot of our goals for today, which were pretty ambitious. Do any of the chairs have anything that they want to say about today?
So with construction, we didn't quite reach our goals, which, like Sydney said, I mean, we weren't really expecting to reach anyway. We did get checks separated. We'll have a bit more work to do on Saturday, but that won't take very long. Huge shout out to Marilyn and her team for the cleanup that she helped out with around lab. Mini Slab actually has a floor now. Woo! Great. Otherwise, it's a good day today.
Yay! Awesome. We're finally ready to do what? To go home. To go home.
Well, you're ready for banquet.
I'm going to use the word extraordinary a lot, which is what the theme for this parade, this float. Earning the extraordinary trophy, the most extraordinary float in the parade, a mighty first for our program.
That's right.
Such successful heights with a team that had over 60% of its members on their first year on the team.
That's great.
Not only because of the award that we won for our amazing float, but also truly for this team. Each and every one of them that I got to work with were extraordinary people.
It's so amazing that there are people out there who are just as passionate as we are about Rose Bowl. It would not be possible without you.
Zach's career goal is to be happy and successful. In reality, his heart belongs to Rose Float when it comes to extracurricular activities. Let's congratulate Zach.
And do my part on the Pomona side, but I also take this moment to say that it has been a true pleasure to work with all of my San Luis Obispo family as well, and for all of them.
I'm just thrilled standards of excellence, because when you think about previous winners, which is going to Disneyland, Trader Joe's, Farmers Insurance, UPS, and Jack in the Box, these are all massive corporations. So when you think about the two schools 80 miles apart with such talented and bright students who come together and achieve this, it is just tremendous. And so I could never be more proud of touting the good work that you've done. And if there are family members, friends or family members, and you didn't quite understand why your child wasn't home during certain breaks and so forth, believe me, they were working very, very hard to showcase talent here at Cal Poly, Pomona, and San Luis Obispo. I'm so proud of you, I'm proud to represent you, and I'm looking forward to the videos because that will tell the real story in terms of what has happened over this past year. Thank you so much.
Being the recipient of the Extraordinaire Award, when we got back in the van after judging down at Rosemont, the judges said one word, all three at the same time, wow. And you as a group, you as students, you should be commended. You won them over. You had them in your first day one, and then when day two came and everything was moving, all of the animation, all the floral decoration was done, it was an easy pick for them to say, this community, this flow needs to be the extraordinaire. Congratulations, and your award's in the mail. Of hope. You have some big shoes to fill because you got to get ready because you'll be here sooner than you think. But congratulations, and on behalf of the judging committee and the Pasadena Tournament of Roses, you guys, you knocked it out of the socks, and We checked the record. This is the first time you guys have won the Extraordinaire Award. Congratulations.
I can never, ever say thank you enough for everything that everyone has given to me. From the students, to the faculty and staff, to our campus community, to our administrators, to our alumni, and certainly to my colleagues as well. It's not easy ever working 3 days straight or, you know, coming in early in the morning when you see the sun and the night come like back to back. But I do it because of the program. I not only believe in the program, I believe in the foundation that the alumni have set, and I believe in the students. And so thank you, students, for all that you do. Continue to do good work in your classes. Make sure you get your grades up and you study a lot. But thank you for all of your commitment. Josh, thank you for putting up with all of my antics, my dancing, off the wall sense of humor. I think we make a really good team in really supporting the students. And I always say oftentimes you will not know who's a Pomona student or a San Luis Obispo student because they're our students, period. We're employees of our respective campuses, but at the greatest, we're employees of the California State University system. And we are the only two campuses that have the joy of building a float for the entire system, one of the biggest systems in the United States. So thank you, Josh, for just being there and having my back and really just being there for the students as well. I appreciate it.
For the sake of time, as well as their sakes and my stories, let's just go one by one and practice the power clap, which is just a single clap after each individual burst out. I start with Cindy Dice, construction assistant, last
that was horrible.
Jamie's son, electronics lead.